Narayanam Namaskritam Naram Saiva Narottamam Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jaya Mudiraye Vedi Ramayane Saiva Prani Bharati Tata Adyuchanti Chamadhecha Hari Sarvatra Giyate Mukam Karoti Vachalam Kangam Langayate Girin Jatkripastamam Vande Sri Guru Dinatarine Paramananda Madhavam Sivadam Tapatrayanamalanam Srimad-Bhagavatam Mahamunikuti Kimbah Pririsvaro Sadya Rudya Varudya Tetrakdivi Sususubhi Tatkana Nigama Kalpatar Kalitam Palam Sukamukhatam Tatrapasanju Ivata Bhagavatam Rasamalayam Uraho Rasikabh Vivavuka Anartho Pasamam Sakhyat Bhakti Jogam Gatakhyati Lokasyan janato vidyam sakri sattata sangitam Jasyan vaisruyamana yan krishni paramapurusi Bhakti rutpadyati punsa sokamo vayapoha Srimata bhagavatam purana mamalam jat vaisnavanam kriyam Jasmin paramahansamika mamalam jnanam parangiyati Tatra jnana viraga bhakti saitam naiskarmyam avishmitam तत्सुणन सुपठन विचारण परो भक्त्याभिमुचे नरो अर्थोऽयं ब्रह्मसूत्राणं भारतार्थो विनिर्णयो गायत्री भाष्यरूपसौ वेदार्थोपरीप्तिः सर्ववेदेति आसानं सारं सारं समुद्रुतं सर्ववेदान्तसारं हि श्रीमद्भागवतं इष्यति तद्रसामृततृप्तस्य नान्यत्र सेदति क्वचित् कृष्णभक्तिरसस्वरूप श्रीभागवत ताति वेदो शास्त्र होते
वासुदेवाय
ॐ नमो भगवती वासुदेवाय Srimad-Bhagavatam, 8th canto, chapter 23, text 11, 12. Sri Suka Uvacha Agyam Bhagavato Rajan Prarado Balinasaho Bhadam Ityamala Prajnyo Mudnadhayo Kurdanjali Parikramyadi Parikramyadi Purusam Sarvasura Chamupati Pranato Sadanu Gyanto Ravi Veso Mahabilam Sri Suka Uvacha Agyam Bhagavato Rajan Rado Balina Saho Pragyo Mudnyadayo Krutanjali Parikramyadi Purusam Sarvasura Chamupati Pranatastadanu Gyanto Pravivesa Mahabilam Sukadeva Goswami said, Sukadeva Goswami kahile, Agyam, the order, Adesh, Bhagavataha, of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Bhagavan Gara, Rajan, O King, Maharaj Parichit, Prahlada, Maharaj Prahlada, Balina Saha, accompanied by Bali Maharaj, Bali Maharaj Saita. Bhadam. Yes, sir. What you say is all right. Abhan jakwele ta thik. Iti das. Epari bhabe. Amala pragya. Prahlad Maharaj, who had clear intelligence. Jum Prahlad Maharaj kara suddha buddhi chila. Murdhani on his head. Ankara mastiskari, adhaya, accepting, swikarkari, kritanjali, with folded hands, badanjali, parikramyaham, after circumambulating, parikramakari, adipurusam, the supreme original person, Bhagavan, parampurusa, adipurusa Bhagavan, sarva asura samupati, master of all the chiefs of the demons. Asuratampati Manankara Prabhu. Pranataha, after offering obeisances, pranam kalapare, tat anujnataha, being permitted by him, Lord Bhamana, Bhagavan Bhamagadara adhishtahim. Pravivesa, enter, praveskale, Mahabhiram, the planet named Nanasutala. Sri Sukavata Agyam Bhagavato Radham Prado Balinasa Bhadam Ityamala Pragyo Murdhyadhaya Kutangali Parikramnadi Purusam Sarvasura Samupati Pranatastadanugyantaha Pravivesa Mahabhiram. Translation by Srila Prabhupada. Sukadeva Goswami said, accompanied by Bali Maharaj, my dear King Parikshit, Prahlad Maharaj, the master of all the chiefs of the demons, took the Supreme Lord's order on his head with folded hands. After saying yes to the Lord, circumambulating him and offering him respectful obeisances, entered the lower planetary system known as Sutala. Athaho sanasang rajan Harir narayan antike Asinang rutvijang madhi sadasi brahmavadinam. Translation by Srila Prabhupada. Hari, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Narayana, thereafter addressed Shukracharya, was sitting nearby in the midst of the assembly with the priests, Brahma, Uta, Udgata, and Adarja. O Maharaj Parikit, these priests were all Brahmavadis, followers of the Vedic principles for performing sacrifices. Translation by Srila Prabhupada. O best of the Brahmanas, Shukracharya, please describe the fault or discrepancy in your disciple Bali Maharaj, who engaged in performing sacrifices. This fault will be nullified when judged in the presence of qualified Brahmana. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. When Bali Maharaj and Prahlad Maharaj had departed for the planet Sutala, Lord Vishnu asked Shukracharya what the fault was in Bali Maharaj, for which Shukracharya had cursed him. It might be argued that since Bali Maharaj had now left the scene, how could his faults be judged? In reply to this, Lord Vishnu informed Shukracharya that there was no need for Bali Maharaj's presence, for his faults and discrepancies could be nullified if judged before the Brahmanas. As will be seen in the next verse, Bali Maharaj had no faults. Shukracharya had unnecessarily cursed him. Nonetheless, this was better for Bali Maharaj. Being cursed by Shukracharya, Bali Maharaj was deprived of all his possessions, with the result that the Supreme Personality of Godhead favored him for his strong faith in devotional service. Of course, a devotee is not required to engage in fruitive activities. As stated in the Shastra, Sarvaharanam Achyute Jaha, Bhagavata, 4th Canto. By worshipping Achyuta, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, one satisfies everyone. Because Bali Maharaj had satisfied the Supreme Personality of Godhead, there were no discrepancies in his performance of sacrifices. O best of the Brahmana Shukracharya, please describe the fault or discrepancy in your disciple Bali Maharaj, who engaged in performing sacrifices. This fault will be nullified when judged in the presence of qualified Brahmanas. In purport, Srila Prabhupada says, when Bali Maharaj and Prahlad Maharaj are departed for the planet Sutala, Lord Vishnu asked Shukracharya what was the fault of Bali, for which you cursed him. So, it might be argued that since Bali Maharaj had now left the scene, how could this fault be judged? In reply to this, Lord Vishnu informed Shukracharya that there was no need for Bali Maharaj's presence, for his faults and discrepancies could be nullified if judged before the Brahmanas. As will be seen in the next verse, Bali Maharaj had no faults. Shukracharya had unnecessarily cursed him. Nonetheless, this was better for Bali Maharaj. His curse came out better because, being cursed by Shukracharya, Bali Maharaj was deprived of his possessions. With the result that Supreme Personality of God had favored him for his strong faith in devotional service. This is better. The curse came out better. Of course, a devotee is not required to engage in fruitive activities. As stated in Shastra, Sarvaharanam Achyute Jaha, by worshipping Achyuta, the Supreme Personal Godhead, one satisfies everyone. Because Bali Maharaj had satisfied the Supreme Personal Godhead, there were no discrepancies in his performance of sacrifices. Shukracharya cursed Bali Maharaj, and his curse came out good. Bali Maharaj was deprived of all his possessions, opulences, in 3 words. Bali, even Shukracharya had cursed like that. When Vaman Dev came, Vaman in dwarf, small stature, Shukracharya understood Shukracharya could understand that this is not a dwarf. He is not a dwarf. He is Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is Supreme Personality of Godhead. A small stature, but he is Vishnu, Bhagavan Vishnu. He is Bhagavan Vishnu. And he'll take away everything that he could understand. So when Bali promised that he would give 3 paces of land, Shukracharya said, "You cannot keep up your words. He is not a dwarf, small stature, he is Bhagavan Vishnu, very great. You'll take away everything from him. You'll be deprived of your all positions. You are possessed in 3 words. You'll be pauper. You cannot maintain yourself, you cannot maintain your family, and you cannot keep up your words. Therefore, you'll go to hell. Sutala, neither planet." That he cursed. You understand? And that course came out very good. The activities of the Supreme Lord, very wonderful, mysterious. Nobody can understand it. Nobody can understand it. You understand? Srudam Sarabhutanam, the well-wishing friend of all living entities. Supreme Lord is the well-wishing friend of all living entities. All his activities are good. There is nothing evil. But we cannot understand it. We cannot. It is not easy to understand the activities of the Supreme Lord. The Supreme Lord, Lord Vishnu, came in the dwarf, form of a dwarf, so tiny, with tiny feet, but became so great. Yeah, took away everything from Bali with 2 feet. All his possessions in 3 words, Bali became deprived of all his possessions, became pauper. Nothing was now there in Bali, with Bali, yes. That means cheating. Yes, he's a great cheater. But that is his mercy. His mercy. You understand? Murugayuriva kapindram vibhadhi lubdha dharma striya makruta virupang striyita kamadanam balim api balimatva vestayat dhan khyabad jaha tadala masita sakhir dustejas tat katharthu. 10th canto of Srimad-Bhagavatam. It is there, 37th chapter. Radharani, in her transcendental madness, delirium, Chitra Dalpa says, Uddhava had come, you understand, to Brajabhumi as a messenger from Krishna, from Mathura, carrying the loving message of Krishna, isn't it? Uddhava looks just like Krishna. Same age, same complexion, everything. But no flute, no peacock feather. Everything same. You understand? Uddhava came from a distance. The gopis saw Uddhava. Look those. Looking just like Krishna. They say, they are, one asked another, "O Sakhi, O friend, who is he? Coming, looking like Krishna. But no peacock feather, no flute. Not Krishna, but looks like Krishna." That's Uddhava. You understand? The messenger. So when Uddhava came nearer, then what Uddhava saw? Such love. They were mad after Krishna. especially Radharani, when came to Radharani, Radharani is mad, transcendental madness, we say Udghurna. This is a technique, what do you say? In English, what do you say that word? Parivashika sabda?
Technical language.
Technical language, yes. Technical language, you say Udghurna, you understand? Udghurna. Udghurna means transcendental madness. Mad person, delirium. Do you understand? So that madness. And Radharani says this thing. Mruga yuri eva kapindam vibhyadhi lubdha dharma striya makruta virupang strijita kamadana bali mapi bali matta here bali. He says, bali mapi bali matta vestraya dvanka vadja stadala masita sakhir dustyaja tadakathartha. Just pointing out a bumblebee had come at that time, bumblebee, you understand? And speaking everything, pointing to bumblebee, but it's all speaking to Uddhava. Radharani says that Krishna, very cruel, no mercy at all. Heart is cruel-hearted. In Ramavatar, he killed a monkey. The king of the monkeys, Bali. Yes. Not face to face fighting. You understand? He hid behind some tree and shot arrow and killed him. Such merciless, cruel person. And again in that Ramavatar, he cut off the nose and ears of Surpanakha, the sister of Ravan. Such cruelity, yes. In Vamanavatar, he cheated Bali, yes. He came, Bali Maharaj offered worship, washed his feet, promised what he said he'd give. But cheated? Yes. Such is your friend, your master, a bumblebee, unreliable, crooked person, merciless, cruel, no heart, heartless person. Yes. Do you understand? If we analyze this thing, we can understand. How they all like leaders, activities of the Supreme Lord is all merciful activities, merciful leader. Yes, no cruelity there. You understand? This is all external only. Surpanakha came, the demoness, the sister of Ravan, saw Lord Ram, very beautiful, handsome, yes, cupid. So she became enchanted and thought of, develops a desire, cherishes a desire in her heart that I must have this person as my husband. Yes. So she came. You understand? But what did Ram do? Ram didn't marry, didn't accept, because Ram is Marjada Purushottama. Follow my language? Is Marjada Purushottama. Never transgresses Ved Marjada, Vedic etiquette, Vedic rule. You understand? So the Nama Avatar, he doesn't transgress. Very strictly follow the Vedmarjada. So only one wife, you'll accept only one wife. You cannot accept more than one wife. That is etiquette, Marjada. So how can you accept Srupanakha? Cannot. But Srupanakha develops a desire. before Supreme Lord, and Supreme Lord must fulfill her desire. Yes. Unless Supreme Lord sanctions, nobody desire will be fulfilled. So, he has to fulfill. You understand? So he didn't marry because he couldn't marry in this avatar. Srupanakha has to wait for the next avatar. He has to wait for it. Next avatar, he will come, will marry many wives. Then his, her desire will fulfill. He will fulfill her desire. So this is very long time. Isn't it? Very long time. Yes, she has to wait. So she cut off, I mean, say, Lord Ram cut off her nose and ears, made her ugly. Because nobody would marry. Lord would marry, nobody would marry. Ugly woman would marry, nobody would marry. And so long, long years she had to wait. That Juga passed. Treta Juga passed. Then next Juga, Dwapar Juga, that Srupanakha came as Kubja, hunchback woman. Hunches are there. Back. Ugly? Would marry. Will marry? Two-legged hog? Nobody would marry. Yes. Nobody would marry. Because only Supreme Lord would marry. Isn't it? It's all mercy. This is mercy. When Krishna came to Mathura, so Kubja came, isn't it? And Krishna tossed her, became so beautiful. Then Krishna married, fulfilled her desire. This is merciless activity, so merciful. So merciful, but it's not easy to understand part of conditioned soul. You understand? There is no merciless, no cruelty here. It's full of mercy. Similarly, the killing Bali, the king of the monkeys. When Bali was killed, Bali's wife, Thara, came, cried, you understand, asked many questions to Lord Ram. She scolded Lord Ram, chastised Lord Ram, called all ill names, cried, "You killed mercilessly my husband, hiding yourself." Ram answered, Lord Ram answered all her questions. The correct answer. You understand? What had Bali done? Bali had committed great offense. Bali had kept the wife of his younger brother Sugriva as his wife. Great offense. And such a characterless person, offender, deserved punishment. Yes. Sugriva is the friend of Lord Ram. The friend's enemy is also enemy. So Bali was the enemy of Lord Ram. And that was the duty of Lord Ram to kill such great offender. And Bali had gotten that course. He has gotten a boon that nobody can kill him with the front-to-front fighting. No, he is unconquerable. Nobody would kill him. He has gotten that boon. So Ram hid himself behind some tree, shot an arrow and killed him. And deserves punishment. So, here is, you know, this is, and he was killed in the hand of Lord Ram, became delivered. There is no harm here. He is not
merciless activity, not cruel like. Then question of cheating body. Vamandev took all his possessions, body's possession, three worlds with 2 feet. You understand? Sword, tiny feet. So tiny feet. But those feet became so great. Isn't it? He expanded himself. Supreme Lord expanded himself. So great, became so great that with 2 feet took away everything. You understand? Bodies, all positions. All positions. When Supreme Lord said, alight, O body, give me the pace for third foot. Body said, O Lord, I have no place. You took away everything with 2 feet. I have no place and you have no foot. Where is your third foot? Bhavandev said, if you can give me place, I'll show my third foot. At that time, pure intelligence came to body. Body had become Kripa Siddha, gotten Kripa, mercy from his grandfather, Prahlad Maharaj, his great devotee Mahabhagavata. Isn't it? So pure intelligence came, the body thought of, I have given everything to Supreme Lord, but I have not given myself. So he showed his head, said, please place your third foot here. That means complete surrender. Complete surrender. Complete dedication. Atmanvedan, self-surrender. Thereby, he pleased the Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord became so much pleased. Surrender is based on pure love. Very often we say so. Sarvadharman paritejya mamekam saranam braja. That is the concluding, most confidential instruction in Gita. Giving up all varieties of dharma, just surrender unto me. So, giving up all varieties of dharma means what? It includes all dharma. It includes Veda dharma also. Do you understand me? Vedic etiquette. It includes. That's no Varjyada dharma, Veda dharma. It includes. Sarva dharma. When can one kick up Veda dharma? Nobody can kick up Veda dharma. If someone will kick up Veda dharma, then he become a sinful person, irreligious person, isn't it? Therefore, Krishna said, Ma sucaha, sarva dharmān paritejya māmekam saraṇam braja antasara pāpebhyo mukhiṣyāmi. Ma sucaha. Isn't it? Ma sucaha. Don't fear. If someone thinks that if I give up dharma, even Veda dharma, then I will become irreligious, a sinful person. Irreligious means sinful. Then Krishna assures, don't fear. I will destroy all sinful reactions. That is what? No fear. Fearlessly you surrender and kick up all dharma. That's based on pure love. Unless one develops pure love for Krishna, cannot kick up Veda dharma. That example is gopi. Example is gopis. They kicked up all Veda dharmas. Isn't it? Dajaste jasodana arjam patham chahitva bheju murkunda padabhi. Sruti bhi mrugyam. Uddhava said this thing. You follow? Uddhava said this thing. When Uddhava saw this gopis, Uddhava saw gopi, Radharani, headed by Radharani, Uddhava, what do you say? What is that English? Chastises himself. Yes, Uddhava chastises himself. Such love for Krishna. They are mad after Krishna. They have given up everything for Krishna. Sleeping, food, eating, sleeping, everything they have given up. They have become skinny, mad. Every moment thinking of Krishna only. Nothing else. Such love they have. And Uddhava chastises himself that I have no such love. Uddhava had some proud. Uddhava had some proud. I am saying I had some pride before coming to Brajbhumi. You understand? Uddhava was Jnani Bhakta. He knows Supreme Lord in Jnana. They are saying, why are you crying for Krishna? Krishna is Supreme Lord, is all pervaded, is everywhere. Yes, isn't it? Saying like that. But these gopis, they have developed so pure love. There is no question of Jnana at all, it's pure love. There is no mixed. It's not mixed bhakti, Mishra bhakti. So pure love, unmixed bhakti. It's not mixed up with Jnana and Aishwarya. So when they are crying for Krishna, Uddhava saw. Uddhava tried to console them saying, don't cry. He's Supreme Lord everywhere, but when at last he saw what love they have developed, pure love. I have no such love. Alas, he chastised himself, I'm such rascal. If I can get some dust from their feet, then my life will be successful. I am able to develop such love. And Uddhava desire to have some dust from them. If I ask, please give me dust, they won't give me. So how my life will be successful? Asama sarana renu jusama so vrindavane kimapi gulmalato sadina dadasthi jasudana arjapatan chaitva bheju mukunda padabhi shruti vimrugyam. That statement of Uddhava in 10th canto. If I'll become a grass or some herbs, some plant here, herbs here in this jungle of Vrindavan, then I will get such chance that their feet may touch me. When they would be searching after Krishna, feeling the pangs of Sivarasana Krishna, by chance their feet might touch me. So I will get some dust. Asama sarana renu jusama so vrindavane kimapi gulmalato sadina darvrindavathadap. Then my life will be successful. What they have not done? Dadustya sudana arjapadanca hitva bhejur mukunda padavi sruti bhimakyam. For mukunda padavi bhajana, for the. Do you understand my language? Mukunda bhajana, Hari bhajana, Krishna bhajana. What they have not done? They have kicked up everything. They kicked up all dharma, even Veda dharma, which is very difficult to kick up. Yes. Lord Ram cannot, Sita Devi cannot, but the gopis kicked up. Yes, isn't it? They have developed such love for Krishna. This is what Sarvadharmaan Paityajya, that example. Uddhava was thinking, if I say, hey, don't cry for Krishna, then I'll become an offender. I'll become an offender. Yes. How can I say don't cry for Krishna? Huh? One must cry for Krishna. If I say don't cry for Krishna, then I'll be an offender. Huh? Because to cry for Krishna is the supreme purusartha. It is prema, it is pure love. It's supreme purusartha. And this supreme purusartha, these dancers, Brajbhumi, the gopis have gotten it. I, myself, Uddhava, have not gotten. I have not gotten. I am Sudaraska. I have not gotten it. They have gotten. How can I tell them, don't cry? Rather, I will say, no, cry more, 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 more. Cry more, cry more. Uddhava was thinking like that. This thought comes to me. Rather, I will say, cry more, cry more, cry. I have no language. I have no language to express. Their bhav, you see. Uddhava said, supreme purusartha is Krishna prema. And you have all gotten that thing. Generally, everybody undergoes some sadhana, does some sadhana, to have some perfection, isn't it? But you have already gotten that perfection. That is Krishna prema. You are worshipable by whole world. What the love, pure love you have gotten, nobody can get it. Do you understand? Sriyo bhir vividhishchani krishne bhakti sadhyate. It is said. This Krishna bhakti, prema bhakti is the supreme attainment, supreme perfection. Generally people undergo some tapasya, give some charity, take some bho, vrata, sudhyayo, japa, chanting, isn't it? To have this perfection, the sadhakas do it. But supreme perfection is to get Krishna prema, and you have already gotten it. That is your whole asset and supreme asset. Therefore, you Brajanganas, the damsels of Brajbhumi, are worshipable by whole world. You are the embodiment of that prema. Uncomparable. There is nobody will be compared to it. What is the sadhyavastus? You understand me? And that is Krishna prema. You are fixed on it. Yes, you have all gotten, you are fixed on it. Buddha gave one example. This burning capacity of the fire. You understand? Burning capacity of the fire. Do you think the fire has earned it? Has fire earned such capacity? Undergoing some sadhana or something like that? No, fire has not earned it. It is fire's own asset, isn't it? It is with him, with the fire. Similarly, this prema, you understand? Pure love for Krishna, that is your whole asset. You have not earned it. Do you understand me? As this example, what you say? I have no language. You please say the language. as the burning capacity is not earned asset of the fire, similarly this prema is not earned asset, it's your whole asset. Do you understand? It's all with you. In Brajbhumi, these damsels of Brajbhumi, you are all worshipable, and the whole universe has become glorified because of the Brajbhumi. And in Braja, you are there, you damsels of Brajbhumi. Therefore, Braja is glorified, the whole world is glorified. Tyagadharma, when you speak of renouncing everything, isn't it? Sarvadharman paritejya. Renouncing everything. Give up all varieties of dharma. Sarvadharman paritejya mamekam saranam braja. You are the embodiment of this shloka. Yes. You are the embodiment of this shloka, the gopis. Yes. Understand my language. I cannot see anybody else but you, the embodiment of this shloka. Dishtya putran pautin dehan sojanan bhav bhavanani cha hitva avranita jajuyam krushnakhyam purusam param. What not? You gave up, you have given up your sons, your husband, home, heart, family men, kith and kin, all asset, everything. For Krishna prema, for loving Krishna. Do you understand? To develop love for Krishna, Param Brahma Krishna, to get that Param Brahma, to have that Param Brahma Krishna as your husband. You have given up everything. Such renunciation. Such renunciation you have done. In this world, people may give up everything. Yes. Sometimes we also see in this material world, people, the adventurous people are there, they give up their life. Yes. They give up their life for what purpose? To get some name, fame and prestige. Yes. Pratishtha. Isn't it? To get some name, fame and prestige, they give up their life. Adventurous activities they do. Some does mountaineering work, expedition to the highest peak of Himalaya, Everest, and dies there. Yes, gives up his life. Some adventurous people goes to Antarctica, for expedition, risky job, sacrificing their life. Yes. Competition, Atlantic Ocean swimming competition, take part, drown in the mid-ocean. They give up with such renunciation. Tyag, what purpose? For name, fame and prestige. But you have given up everything for what purpose? To get Krishna as husband. Krishna prema. Such renunciation incomparable. I never see anybody in this world who has with such a renunciate, given up everything for Krishna. Do you understand? This is all the thoughts of Uddhava. You don't know anybody but Krishna, this Krishna Priti, the love of Krishna, and tyag, renunciation for Krishna, for this Parama Purusartha, Supreme Purusartha, that is Krishna Prema. That is Mahabhava, Sarvatma Bhava, Adhikruta Bhavati, Nang Adhukhyaji. Mahabhava Mai. Gopis are Mahabhava Mai. Radharani is Mahabhava Mai. You understand? This Mahabhava is in the eighth place. isn't it? Eighth place. What is that? Last thing. Prema, Sneha, Mana, Pranaya, Raga, Anuraga, Bhava, Mahava. Eighth place. Last thing. The gopis are embodiment of Mahabhava. They are Mahabhavamai. Radharani is Mahabhavamai. Do you understand? Even Lakshmi Devi cannot have it. But to speak of others, part of Lakshmi Devi, it's very difficult to get this Mahabhava. You have gotten it, you are the embodiment of that Mahabhava. You damsels of Brajbhumi. And you have developed such prem, such love for, pure love. How is it that you feel the pangs of separation from Krishna? This thing, you feel the pangs of separation from Krishna? So fortunate you are. It is all external affair. Your such feeling, pangs, separation, all external affair. There is no question of feeling separation at all. It's all external. Yes, that's a fact. Viraha, do you understand? Viraha, viraha means separation. The Sanskrit word viraha is externally viraha. Yes. Internal union, that is viraha. Yes. That's external. Externally is viraha. Externally Krishna is not with them. But Krishna is with them in their heart. Internally union, that is viraha. That is therefore topmost position in the platform of love. That is viraha. Vipralambha bhava. And you are all the embodiment of that bhava, mahabhava. You gopis. Virahena mahabhaga mahan me anugraha krutaha. Uddhava says, I cannot find out any reason. Why you feel so much pangs of separation? Why such viraha? Uddhava says, why? I cannot find out any reason. Only I think of that. Your this viraha is only for me to show favor to me. You understand? Uddhava said, only to show favor to me, you express such viraha, manifest such viraha. What do you say? Understand the language? Virahena mahabhaga mahan me anugraha. Me anugraha, in order to show a favor to me, you are in this viraha bhava. Do you understand? What is that? This prema, pure love for Krishna, very powerful thing. I have heard and I have this belief. But I have never seen such person. I have heard about this prema and I have this belief, faith. But I have never seen. Now I saw the embodiment of that Mahabhava prema. All you are. Do you understand my language? Uddhava says like that. If you would not have felt such viraha, understand my language? Why should I come here? Krishna would not have sent me here. Understand? Krishna would not have sent me here if you would not have felt such viraha. So your viraha is to show favor unto me. Understand me? Understand? Is that difficult to understand? Just here? If you cannot understand, just here? Time will come when your consciousness will purify, then you can understand it. Now just here, if you cannot understand. It's not easy thing to understand. You understand? He understands little, he says little. Uddhava says, this prema is a very powerful thing. I have heard about this prema and I have faith in it, but I have never seen it. Now I saw. Then I saw you. That's the embodiment of Mahabhava. You understand? If you not have felt such viraha, then Krishna would not have sent me here. Ah? Understand me? Krishna would not have sent me here. Ah? Again, I would not have gotten such good fortune to come to this Vrajabhumi. It's such a favor to me. Your viraha means to show favor to me. Understand? Ah? Understand? What Uddhava is thinking? Mahabhava with your embodiment, Mahabhava. I am so fortunate, I feel myself so fortunate that I could see you now. This is my good fortune. Question is there. This question of prema, it is without designation, nirupadhi prema. Isn't it? No designation here. Designation is there only material world. Isn't it? There's no question of designation in spiritual world, and your prema, this love, is not lost, it's not material, it's pure, complete, pure, unmixed. No mixture of jnana and aishwarya, so this is nirupadhi prema. Where is the question of viraha in this nirupadhi prema? Understand my language? This is Uddhava's thought. Then Uddhava says, it is only to show favor to me, Uddhava, who is a jivadhama, what is this? Most, most fallen jiva, best. Only to show for favor to me. This is, therefore you are such viraha. Otherwise, no question of viraha. Uddhava says. So how the gopis? Uddhava glorifies them. Uddhava is glorifying them. But when Uddhava was glorifying, they couldn't feel happy. They couldn't feel themselves happy. So in the mind they thought, oh Uddhava, what type of human being you are? Those who are distressed, feeling such acute distress, you are glorifying them. What sort of human being you are, Uddhava? Do you think by such glorification will you give us some relief? Of our pain, the pain we feel in our heart. Such pain is so acute pain, so distressing. We are just on the verge of dying. And you are glorifying us. And do think that by such glorification you will give us relief. Don't do it. Don't do it. We are most unfortunate in this whole world. And you are glorifying us, Uddhava. For this purpose have you come here? Understand? Don't you know? Whose throat is parched, feeling acute thirst. What he needs? He needs water, some drink. Isn't it? Without such drink, the thirst cannot be satisfied. So, we feel such acute pang of sipas, such pain in our heart because of our Lord, of our beloved husband Krishna. Yes. But you are glorifying us. This will never give us solace, a relief. Give something to us that will give us a relief, this pain that we're feeling. Do you understand? Rather by glorifying you are putting fire, I putting ghee into fire. Understand? Then Uddhava could understand what a mistake he is committing. He could understand what mistake he is committing. Then Uddhava said, alight, O themselves of Brajabhumi gopis, Sriyatang Priyasandesaha, I have come here with the loving message from Krishna. Now here. Now here, Sruyatam Priya Sandesa. Then the gopis say, Uddhava, no need of saying this thing. Please tell us, make such arrangement if we can get him immediately. Don't let us hear all these things. Understand? Uddhava says, Bhavatinam Sukhavah, what I am going to deliver you, the Krishna has sent with me, that will be very, very pleasing to you. Sukhavah, very, very pleasing to you. Please listen to it. You understand? Then Uddhava will say, what Krishna has sent. These are loving exchanges. You understand? Uddhava Sandesh. It is from Uddhava Sandesh. So many things. So my point is here, just as a matter of reference and context, I tell this thing, but it doesn't, is not connected with this topic. I am a greedy fellow. I cannot suppress my greed. I don't know whether you are greedy or not. You are not greedy, huh? Greedy? No, greedy. He is not greedy. So I am greedy fellow. Because when I spoke that thing, Radharani in her transcendental madness spoke about this body, Vamana's cheating to body, or cheater the merciful incarnation. And body is faultless. He has no fault at all. Because that is there. That Supreme Lord says, why did you curse him? Why did you curse him? That body. Ask Shukracharya. Isn't it? Body is faultless. No fault at all. You are cursing unnecessary. Unnecessary. It is said here. In that reference, we talk of these things. And otherwise, no need. Another point is there, this course came out blessing, I said, explained. Many instances are there, course of Narada Muni to Nala Kubera, Manigruba came out blessing. Yes, though they are cursed to remain as trees for in Martyapura, in this material planet, but they remained in the form of two Arjuna trees in the courtyard of Nanda Maharaj for 36,000 years. 36,000 years. But it came out such blessing that they got the touch of Krishna. Yes. If they would have passed 36,000 of lives, they could not have gotten touch of Krishna. So that such course came out blessing. Similarly, this, what is that? One Brahman caused Mahaprabhu, Nimai Pandit in Nadia, Pasandi Brahman, smart Brahman. I curse you. You cannot remain in your home. You leave home. You cannot enjoy your wife. I curse you. Yeah. So Nimai Pandit danced in jubilation. That is blessing to me. You understand? That is blessing to me. So he left home, took up sannyas, renounced his young wife, newly wedded wife Vishnu Priya. Yes. renounced his newly wedded wife, maiden, young wife Bhishmapriya, left home, took up sannyas, and distributed nam prem. So that is blessing. So this course of Shukracharya turned out blessing for Bali. Yes. Bali was deprived of all his possessions. You understand? That's why he surrendered and he developed such love for Supreme Lord that he, Supreme Lord became bound up with that love. He said, now I am there, at your gate. I become a gatekeeper now. You'll see me always. Nobody will take care of this opulence. Enjoy. I'm there. It is not important that Supreme Lord inflicted punishment on Bali, externally cruelty, cheating, but such mercy, source of mercy. Supreme Lord bound up Bali in the Varuna Pass of the rope of snakes, naga, snake rope. Do you understand? Varuna Pass, such punishment. This is all external. Supreme Lord imprisoned Bali. This is not important. Supreme Lord himself became imprisoned by Bali. Yes. Because Bali bound up Supreme Lord with the rope of love, when he completely surrendered, dedicated himself, self-dedication. That is question of love. Without that love, pure love, nobody can completely surrender. Sarvadhamman paritejya mame kum saranam gaja. Giving up all varieties of dharma, just surrender. It includes Veda dharma. Gopis are the embodiment of this mantra. That I said. Uddha said, you are the embodiment of this mantra. Sarvadharman paritejya mame kum saranam gaja. It's fixed. Pure love. Without that pure love, nobody would surrender unto Krishna. Your so-called surrender without love is either partial, artificial, or conditional. Not true love. Yes. Krishna prema raiyeko apurva prabhava guru samalaghuke karaya dasya bhava. This is the wonderful effect of Krishna prema that makes everybody das, Krishna das. His gurujan, his superiors, his equals, our boys, and inferiors, raktakapatra, everybody is das, based on pure love. This is the wonderful effect of Krishna prema. Krishna prema rabhubhava. Sarvadharmana paritejya mame kusana. Understand? And gopis are the embodiment of that, manifestation of that, this mantra, sarvadharmana paritejya mame. That is the answer. Therefore I said that, all right? Understood? Understood? This is question of love. When body dedicated, self-dedication, so completely showed his head, put a third foot, he developed that love. The Supreme Lord became bound up. He stayed at the door. In Sutala, a door. He became doorkeeper. I am at the door. And the gatekeeper. Nobody will come and take care. Enjoy. You will see me every day, daily, every moment. I am there. So, this is important. It's not important that Supreme Lord bound up Bali. It is most important, more important, much more important that Supreme Lord himself became bound up by Bali. Yes. The rope of love. This is Atmanvedan. So, it's all external. Somebody, those who cannot understand, they say, Supreme Lord's activity, how do you say that he is merciful? Very merciless, cruel. Yes, such activities, I said. Cut off the nose and ears of Supanakha, killed Bali, the king of monkeys. Not in face-to-face fighting, hiding, and cheated body, bound up body, isn't it? Inflicted such punishment on the body, a merciless activity, cruel activity, cruel person. hard-hearted person. Yes, is external, isn't it? But how merciful it is. All these activities, is not easy thing to understand. Only those are devotees, dear devotees, those are developed such love for Krishna, only they can understand it, otherwise nobody can understand.
You said with the love you cannot surrender.
No.
But you said it's when you surrender that only develop such love. So it's like impossible.
He developed love, therefore surrender. Otherwise how could have surrendered? And how he got? He's got up by the mercy of his grandfather Prahlad, his great Mahabharata. By his mercy he developed such thing. I say, then Lord Brahman said, how can you keep up your promise, O Bali? Give me the place for your, my third port. Bali had nothing now. He is deprived of everything, all his possessions, 3 worlds. Now he is going to be proved a liar. He cannot keep up his promise. That course Sukracharya has given, you cannot keep up your promise. You'll be a great offender. Liar, you'll go to hell. Now he's pushed to hell in Sutala. Yes. But how his course turned out blessing, you see, that we are explaining, do you understand me? Sukracharya's cursed, turned out blessing. Bali got so much mercy, favor from Supreme Lord. He bound up Supreme Lord with the rope of love. Isn't it? Completely dedicated himself. When Supreme Lord asked, how can you keep up your promise? Where is it? Show me the place now where I place my third foot. What Bali said, oh Lord, I have no place and you have no foot. So if you show me the place, I'll show my foot. So at that time, thought of, I have given everything but I have not given myself. How came to you? This is the mercy of Prahlad Maharaj. This self-dedication, Atman-Vidana, is based on love. This is my mercy of great Bhagavata, Mahabhagavata, Prahlad Maharaj. You understand? So he surrendered. Means he bound up. Supreme Lord is the rope of love. Yes. Understand?
So you said without love you cannot surrender. Without surrender you cannot get love.
Without love, you cannot surrender. Your so-called surrender is either partial, artificial, or conditional.
Also, without surrender, you cannot get love. Without love, no surrender, without surrender, no love.
Without surrender, no love. No, without love, you cannot surrender. That is not the vice versa. Understand? That is not vice versa. Without love, you cannot surrender. When Bali surrendered, showed his head, thought of, I have given everything but I have not given myself, he has already developed love.
But sometimes you quote that verse, you know, Achyutananda Prema Kali Bhare Dhanam, Bhagatala Prema Dhanam,
give love, therefore surrender. Teaches Saranagati is based on love.
Love comes first.
Yes. Without love you cannot surrender. Without love your so-called surrender is not true surrender. It's either partial, conditional or artificial.
That love you get with pure chanting.
Yes. If your chanting is pure, then it develops its love. That Mahaprabhu gives that love through chanting this Nam Neva Prada through the holy name. Then you surrender. How can you surrender without love? Without love you cannot surrender. Your surrender may be artificial, partial or conditional. Not true? Yes. Understand? confusion goes. Clarified. So, atyanta durlava prema karivare dana sikhaya sanagati bhagater pran. What is that? In order to give love, teaches sanagati. That means, he gives love through chanting, therefore teaches surrender. Get love, surrender. Yes. Otherwise, how can one give up all varieties of dharma? I said, the embodiment of this mantra, Uddhava says, you are, you gopis. So, sarvasman paritejya mameka usanam praja. The embodiment, manifestation, embodiment of this mantra, you are, O gopis. What is that? It's based on love. You have done such love for Krishna, and you have given up everything. It's very difficult to give up. Jadastirja. That I explain.
So, full surrendering is a consequence of pure love.
Yes, it's based on pure love. That is the effect of Krishna Prema. Krishna Prema Rai Apurva Prabhava, Guru Sabha Laghuke Kuraya Dasyava. That I was explaining on the Gaur Purnima day, next day, isn't it? How Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda Mata, cowherd boys, gopis, Radharani, all, even Baladev, all are das. Without the love, you cannot become Krishna Das. No. You have not become Krishna Das if you have not developed such love. So it is loving service. Das means what? Servant. To render service. What sort of service? Loving service. Premamayi seva. Loving service. There is adjective in this service. It is not mere service. There is an adjective. It's a loving service. Premamayi seva. It's based on pure love. If you have no love, how can render service? How can become das? You have not become das. Only you are cheating das. Cheating. Only cheating. Yes. Just pretending. Pretension. Only pretending. Yes. Pretending. And cheating. Hypocrisy. Nothing else. It's a hypocrisy. Nothing else. Yes. No true das. You cannot become true das of Krishna without love. It's based on love. And it is loving service. Not mere service. And Krishna will never accept if there is no love. Yeah, never accept. Yeah, understand? Patram pusum palam toyam. So one point I was saying, jasmin tuste jagat tusta. If Krishna is satisfied, pleased, then the whole world will be satisfied and pleased because he is source of elimination. Ang sarvasya prabhava matva sarvam pravartate iti matva avasante mangrudha avasamannita. I am the source of all emanations, everything has emanated from me, the source of creation. Anadi radiri govinda sarva karana karanam, the cause of all causes. He is anadi, he has no beginning, but he is the beginning of everything and everybody, isn't it? If Krishna will be pleased, Krishna will be satisfied, then whole world, everybody will be pleased and satisfied. Jasmin tuste jagat tusta. This is said here. Body pleased the Supreme Lord. Isn't it? Supreme Lord is so much pleased with body. Yes. He gave so much thing. Such favor he got. Yes. Isn't it? He himself became bound up by the rope of love of body. Stayed there as doorkeeper, gatekeeper. Yes. Such favor. He is so much satisfied, so much pleased with body. So how can we say there is fault with the body? That you cursed Sukracharya, he is asking. Now it is to be discussed in the presence of Brahmanas. Then it will be nullified. That is our topic here, isn't it? Next verse says that no, body had no fault at all. The fault, how can he develop such love for Krishna, for Supreme Love? How he gets such favor from Supreme Love? Is that fault? just means to stay, jagat to stop. Whole world will be satisfied if Supreme Lord is satisfied. Jathātaranmula nisacanam tripyanti tatskanda vijaposākha pranāpaharātsa jatindyānita deva sarvārana machyutejya. If you pour water at the root of the tree, the whole tree will get. Branches, sub-branches, twigs, leaves, fruits, flowers, everything you get. No need of separate watering. If you give water to the food to the stomach, the whole body will be nourished. No need of separate giving to eye, ear, nose, hand, legs. Sadharana machyutejya, Lord Achyuta will be worshipped. Supreme Lord will be worshipped and will be satisfied and pleased. The whole world, everybody will be pleased. Yes. This is stated here. In Parapat Prabhupada said. That story is there in Mahabharata. Mahabharata story. Isn't it? Pandavas were staying in the forest. They were banished. You understand? With their wife Draupadi. You understand? Five husbands, wife Draupadi. Staying in the forest. Banished. Nothing. They were deprived of everything. This Duryodhana, the eldest son of Dhritarashtra, very crooked person, politician, great politician, duplicitous, conspirator, so much conspiracy he makes. So once he invited Durvasa Muni with his thousands of disciples. I gave them sumptuous food, nice food, ate them, made them satisfied. Then asked Durvasa, Pandavas are staying there in that forest to please go to them one day with your thousands of disciples. And you must go in the afternoon, don't go in the forenoon. And Durvasa was pleased, yes. He said, I'll go. So Durvasa went one day to the Pandavas after 12. Yudhishthir very strictly follows the religious principles, dharma niti. You understand? He is known as dharma raja. Very strictly follow the principles of religion. This is the duty of grihastha. If a guest comes, atithi, atithi means without prior notice comes. You understand? That is atithi, guest. And to serve that guest, give him nice food, nice seat, everything, treat him nicely, satisfy him, offer worship, that is grihastha dharma, atithi seva. You understand? Grihastha dharma. If you won't do, then you'll disgrace the principles of dharma. You'll become an offender. Lord, Supreme Lord Narayana will never be pleased with you. That is grihastha dharma, atithi seva. You understand me? So Durvasa Muni arrived there with thousands of disciples. Immediately Yudhishthira Maharaj came, paid obeisances, washed his feet and invited him, please, now it is afternoon, go quickly, take bath, finish your afternoon ritualistic ceremony, and he go, come, take food, that's the duty, do you understand? Invite, that's dharma. So Durvasa went with his disciples, thousand disciples, to take bath nearby spring, rivulet. You understand? They were taking bath. At that time, the problem came to Draupadi. Because Yudhishthira will ask Draupadi, bring food for the guest. But Draupadi cannot give food. There is no food at all. You understand? As long as Draupadi had not taken food. She can feed any number of guests. She has gotten such boon. Any number of guests come, thousands of guests come, she can feed. Her cooking pot will never be empty. It will always be full. Yes, she has such boon. But if she takes food, it cannot feed. It is empty, it becomes empty, cooking pot. So Draupadi has already taken her food and washed the pots, everything finished. So now this problem came, how can I feed the guests? So who can save me, protect me in this danger? It's great danger now, yes. So thought of only Krishna can protect me, nobody can protect because he is our friend. Vipada bandhu, one who helps you in the danger is the real friend, yes. And Krishna is the real friend, yes, he protects. He already protected us from so many dangerous situations. Then after prayer, cried prayer from the core of her heart and asked, Krishna, please protect me in this dangerous situation. The Krishna was at that time in Dwarka. Do you understand? Dwarka. Immediately, Krishna. Because devotee's prayer, so his heartfelt prayer coming out from his heart. Gour of the heart, devotees of prayer, so powerful, goes, penetrating everything, goes to Golok Vrindavan. Such telephone is there, it's ringing, 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 ring, 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 ring. Who is calling? Draupadi calling. Yes, such telephone. Have you invented such telephone? Then Krishna is running, coming, breathlessly. Running, shouting from the distance, Draupadi, 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 I am very hungry, give me food. Yes. Then came nearer, Draupadi, please listen, I won't listen to you, anything, please first give me food, then I'll listen. Draupadi, that is my problem. Therefore I am calling you, I telephone you. What problem, no food? No food, none, there must be some food for me. You see, bring your cooking pot to me, must be some food for me. So that day, Draupadi had cooked some saag, leafy vegetable saag. Only tiny leaf, one tiny leaf was there, stuck to the brim of that pot. It was not washed off. Oh yes, it is here. Took that tiny leaf and took. Became so much satisfied, oh, so much you paid me. My belly is full now, stomach is full. Drank one glass of water, it's full. Draupadi, you paid so much. My belly is heavy now. And young, oh, I'm sleep now. So, Drubasa Muni, his 1,000 disciples are taking bath. Their stomach barely becomes so heavy. They cannot lift themselves from the water. Yeah. One of the disciples said, oh, Gurudev, amazing, wonderful, what is this? His belly is so heavy, I cannot lift myself. Dhruva says, so is the case with me also. So is the case with me also. Dhruva says, how is it? Krishna took only a tiny leaf, saag leaf, became so much pleased, satisfied, the belly is filled. Jasmin Pushte, Jagat Pushta. If Krishna, the Supreme Lord, will be pleased, satisfied, all world will be satisfied. And that's proof. This is indicated here. Body pleased the Supreme Lord with his service. Got so much favor. How is it that Bali committed some mistake, some wrong that you cursed him? Shukracharya. Let us discuss it. That is all. Thank you.